Hello, my dear students. In this lecture, we are going to see one previous year GATE numerical. This question was asked in GATE 2019. Now, basically, this question is based on finding safe factor, which is one of the topic of radiation. Very interesting question. Let us understand the question. Three set of parallel plates LM, NR, and PQ are given in the figure 1, 2, and 3. Now in figure 1, plate L with plate M is given. In figure 2, N and R plates are given. And in figure 3, P and Q plates are given. The view factor Fij is defined as the fraction of radiation leaving plate I, and that is intercepted by plate J. That we know. Then assume that the value of FLM and FNR are now here. The value of FLM is given, FLM which is equal to 0.8, right, and FNR is 0.4, FNR is equal to 0.4 respectively. The value of FPQ round off to the one decimal place is, now value of FPQ is equal to question mark, right. Now here the safe factor of L with respect to M is given. Safe factor of N with respect to R is given. Now safe factor of P with respect to Q, that is for figure 3 they are asking. Now my dear students, let us do some modifications in figure 1 and figure 2. Now can I say, for figure 1, let us say this M I am going to divide in 3 stages or 3 parts. Let us say I am doing 3 parts of M. Part 1, that is 1 meter part, 1 meter part and 1 meter part. Right. Let us say this M is A, B, C. A is first 1 meter, B is another 1 meter, C is another 1 meter, right. Therefore, can I say, here FLM is equal to, the safe factor of L with respect to M is equal to FLA plus FLB plus FLC. That is safe factor of L with respect to A plus safe factor of L with respect to B plus safe factor of L with respect to C. This is how we can write, right. And my dear students, for this plate L, the part of M, that is A and C, are symmetric or not? Here, for this L, the A and C are symmetric. Therefore, we can say the FLA is equal to FLC. Therefore, here FLM will become equal to, here FLA plus FLC will be twice FLA or twice FLC. Let us write twice FLA. Twice FLA plus FLB. Right, this is one relation. Now, my dear students, let us go to the figure 2. Now, for figure 2, N and R. Now, exactly below N. Now, L and N. L is 1 meter, N is also 1 meter. L and N are exactly similar. And this R is exactly similar to part B. Can I say? This R is exactly similar to part B of this figure 1. Therefore, for this R, we can say B also. Right. Therefore, here we can say the FLB is equal to FNR. And FLNR is given. FNR is given 0.4. Therefore, is equal to 0.4. So, here FLB we have calculated. So, let us put this value in this equation. Therefore, FLM is nothing but 0.8, right, is equal to 2 into FLA plus FLB is 0.4, right. So my dear students, from this 2 FLA is equal to 0.4, therefore FLA will be equal to 0.2. And already we have seen FLA, the safe factor of L with respect to A and safe factor of L with respect to C is symmetry, because of symmetry is same, therefore is equal to FLC. Right, but here question is to find P with respect to Q, that is FPQ. Now, can I say this P, N and L are exactly similar? It is 1 meter length. L, N and P are exactly similar. And below this P, there is Q. And below this P, this first 1 meter of this Q is exactly below this P. Can I say this 1 meter of this here up to this, let us say up to this, is Q to this point, right, exactly below 1 meter, first 1 meter is exactly similar to R and R is similar to B. Therefore, can I say this is as B? And my dear students, after B, from this another 1 meter is exactly similar to C. Can I say exactly similar to C? Therefore, it is C. It is C. Right. Therefore, here we can say here EF P to Q will be equal to EF P to B plus EF P to C. This is how we can say. And my dear students, EF P to B, this P to B is exactly similar to EN to R, is exactly similar to EN to R, or exactly similar to EL to B. Right. Therefore, exactly similar to EF EL to B. Therefore, this EF P to B will be equal to 0.4 because EN to R is 0.4. Now, my dear students, again, this P to C is similar to EL to C. Definitely, right. P to C is similar to EL to C. Therefore, this EF P to C is equal to EF EL to C. And EL to C is nothing but 0.2. Therefore, EF P to C is equal to 0.2. Right. So, my dear students, this EF P to C is equal to 0.2 and EF P to B is equal to 0.4. Let us put here. Therefore, we can say EF P to Q is equal to EF P to B plus EF P to C, which is equal to 0.4 plus 0.2, which is equal to 0.6. So, my dear students, here for this question, this EF P to Q in this fill in the blanks, you have to type 0.6 for getting 2 marks. Thank you, dear students. In next lecture, we will see one more numerical on this topic, which was asked in previous year GATE examination.